it's there. So it has. Moss, a big day for him today. Plenty of championships on the line.
Hey, this is where the nerves can get shredded. This is where you've somehow, amidst wanting to be as quick as you possibly can, you've got to have a racing head on, Steve. How do you do it?
Well, a kid has got to be nervous after that mechanical failure yesterday. That has to be playing on his mind. This man, McKinley Carl Paz, he knows what he needs to do. It's victory or nothing for him. It's on for young and old out there, mostly young.
McKinley Carl Paz with a black helmet on the right-hand side of your screen. Let's see how he gets away. It's 8 laps of the 4.5-kilometre Buram circuit. Aki Nasiz, maybe just playing a little bit of mind games there. He's last to get in onto the grid, so everyone else has got a long start. Aki feeling fresh, feeling pumped up. The red lights are off, and we are away. It's a decent start from Aziz Farooz. Aki Nasiz has got off to a good start as well. From P4, he's got himself up at least one position. And as they come into the first bend, Aki Nasiz is in P3. That's a terrific start for the Malaysian.
Yeah, really just what he did. McKinley Carl Paz is back in the pack, probably about 7th or 8th position at the moment. He won't be too worried just yet. Zed Zaid is there too. A nice start. There's Alvis Satay on the number 570 machine on the left-hand side there. A big gaggle as we expect. Fendi Rosli's in the middle of that group too. All the major players are up the front.
Now Fendi Rosli will take the lead going into the turn number 3. The long hairpin at the end of the long straight. And then they come into this turn 4, which has caused problems. You can see one or two of the riders being forced off the racing line. This corner 4, though, look at this 6 abreast. Contact is almost guaranteed.
Nice and clean on the first lap, and everybody through, which is good to see. Looks like out the front's Waiyaji Triliksana.
Waiyaji Triliksana for the 1XX team, and he's taking Aki Nasiz with him. Aki Nasiz, stay somewhere near the front, is what we heard McKinley Carl Paz say. Well, Aki Nasiz is the man who's really taken that one to heart. There he is, 570, is Aldi Satya. Aki Nasiz, number 13, tries to keep himself out of trouble. He's got the white helmet. Where's it? The black helmet of McKinley Carl Paz. He's not too far behind in P9 at the moment.
Yeah, you know, I mean, Aki Nasiz has to beat McKinley Carl Paz if he wants to win this championship. Remember, there's 3 points in it between those two guys, so Aki Nasiz has got to have the ride of his life here today.
So coming through, Ahmed Fazli Shah, bike 46, 17 is Mazzato. Mazzato does that really nicely and is able to hold on to that line. They're through the start-finish line for the first time in a bit of a line. It's Ahmed Fazli Shah, Aki Nasiz, Wayu Haji Jilaksana, Mazzato, Aldi Satya, and Hafiza Rufa, who are all really close.
A little bit of interesting news, McKinley Carl Paz is back down in 22nd position, 2.5 seconds off, so McKinley Carl Paz has got himself in the back of this group now. Obviously had some sort of issues. You can see him there, right at the back of the group. He's got a lot of hard work to do now.
On the front end, let's keep an eye on 98, Izzat Zaidi. Little touch there for Fendi Rosli as well. Ahmed Fazli Sham on the green, 146. And Wayu Haji Triliksana, the 1XOX team, are indeed doing exactly as you suggested. They're grouping together and trying to create opportunities because Ahmed Fazli Sham does have a shout in this title.
He certainly does. If something was to happen to the two other contenders, he would be the champion. And I'll tell you what, you cannot count anything out when you've got riders going 5 wide into a corner like they're about to do now. This
fantastic. And it's your Fauzi, bike 177, confusing the pitch as well. McKinley Carl Paz, look at the 1XOX guys. It's Wayu Haji Triliksana and Ahmed Fazli Shah. Taken out. That's one of the Cardinals racing team. It's not one of the competitors, but it's Aldi Satya, I think, is one of those. Yeah. Aldi Satya is off the bike. He's trying to get himself up and running. He has them once again. Corner 12 takes its first victim.
And it could have been Saeed as well. He's gone down here. Let's just have a quick look. And yeah, it is. It's Roseman Saeed who's gone down with him. So, and boy, that was lucky. One of the Uber racing bikes ran wide there.
Okay, Hasik it was who ran wide. Let's not forget that Hasik has got half a chance as well. He's in P8 at the moment. Aki Nasiz in P9, so he's not in the leading group. But for him, he's just going to be very aware of where 32 into joining this first group. There is the casualty.
Unfortunately, you can just see how disappointed he is in that. He knew he was in for a shot at victory in this race. He was in that leading group, and bang, just like that, all over.
Peter Krishna is out as well, and Jan Antoine is having a tough time. And you had Hafiza Rosa, and that's three of the 31 starters are now no longer part of this race, where only two, a quarter of the way through.
Racing team riders up the front at the moment. I think, can it?
So, Hazik Fairuz is okay.
McKinley Kalpaz.
And McKinley Kalpaz.
It's okay. Was that number 13?
Akitas
is out. Two mechanical DNFs. Why did he lose the championship? So disappointed for him.
Wow.
Des. Can you believe that?
I'm pretty sure it's Akitas, the white helmet, and the look of disbelief in the
Big crash!
That is a big crash.
Didn't quite.
In fact, three have been taken out in the open countryside. Two of the riders are okay, one is still down.
Just have to wait and see who they are. That is number. Not sure, that could be Amber Garcia, the wild card. And perhaps, not sure who that is. Can't quite read the number at the moment. But meanwhile, back in the pits, for Akitas, that is just bad news for him, isn't it? Terrible.
It's terrible for him, but it's an opportunity for McKinley Kalpaz. He just needs to make sure he stays relatively close. We have got four laps to go. Here's Etzani Ahmed Fazli, Sharpbike 46 is there. Hazik Fairuz is there. With Akitas is out of the equation. A victory here, and if McKinley Kalpaz is in the 6th, 7th, 8th region, there could be a surprise winner. Wow. 98 is Atsani. He's leading the way just at the moment.
Yeah, we've seen things twist and turn around, and I'll tell you what, it could still happen. There is a number 46 machine.
So, confirmation, Akitas is Amber Garcia, Peter Pongla-Boypeng, and Aditya Fauzi. They have all dropped out of this race as well. Akitas was leading the championship coming into the final round. He has got two DNFs, two mechanical failures to blow, literally, his opportunity of taking the title.
It says he's ADF front for the number 98 machine at the moment. He's doing a really good job for the RCB. That's NY Yamaha 1-1 Bank Racing Team.
Ahmed Fazli Shab takes the corner, the sharp left on turn four. He takes with him Hazik Fairuz. These two, I tell you what, Steve Martin, these two could be battling it for the title. Depends where McKinley Kalpaz is at the moment in P3. There is Akid, lonely on his own, out in the countryside. No friends, no fight. What a nightmare day.
Gonna be disappointed for him. He pushed the bike back yesterday. He went in a hurry, ran it back to the pit so that they could prepare the bike for today. But for whatever the reason is, perhaps there was an electronic problem with the bike that was putting the engine under stress. Whatever it is, perhaps he was over-revving it into the corners too much. But two mechanical failures here for Akitas has destroyed his championship hopes.
123, here's McKinley Kalpaz. There is his shot. Mazzato is 17. Look out for Mazzato. He's there. 27, just behind in the white helmet is Hazik Fairuz, but it's Ahmed Fazli Shah who goes very, very wide and loses 3, 4, 5, 6 places, 3 laps to go. And Fernando Mazzato, McKinley Kalpaz, 1, 2, 3, 4.
It would be great to see Wawa well able to feature on the podium in this one after yesterday's disappointment. He's certainly got the pace in the racecraft. Absolutely, that is the thing that he does need to consider. But we've got some new players up the front now, and it is Richie Torreira. We haven't spoken much about him, but he has finally got himself towards the front. He's been playing it pretty cool at the back there.
Mazzato comes through, 2 laps to go. Wayu Adjiturksana from Richie Torreira, Shaul Lamin, Ahmed Fazli Shab, Mazzato, Fitri Asaf. Tell you what, he's dropped down. McKinley Kalpaz has dropped down to 14th position.
Well,
what is going on?
It doesn't matter in retrospective. What all McKinley Kalpaz has to do is finish the race. And he'll be okay.
But Ahmed Fazli Shab, if Ahmed gets a Ahmed Fazli Shab by 46, if he takes maximum points, 20 points, then you've got a problem for McKinley Kalpaz. Mazzato 17 leads coming round the long hairpin at the end of the long straight.
Yeah, you're right. He's got to be careful at the moment, Fasnacham. I don't know if he would be calculating that out there at the moment either. Hopefully he's getting some good information from his team. They should be holding the ball down over the wall, telling him what position he needs to finish in to be champion. His biggest problem is he needs to stay out of trouble as we head into the with 1.5 laps to go.
Round turn four, there's been a number of casualties. We've had 8 riders are now not on the track, including the championship.
Oh!
Now that's a massive...
That's an Uber racing machine, that is! Is that McKinley Carpaz with the black helmet?
Let's have a look. It's a huge...
It is!
120.
He's gone down!
Carpaz has crashed, but he's back up and running. But that could be the end of him. And Hasik Fairuz and Ahmed Fasnacham are in brilliant positions to maybe go on and take an incredible title victory.
Well, this could come down to the wire now. It could be the man in third position, Hasik Fairuz, who wins this championship. If he wins this race, he will be the champion.
So Hasik Fairuz, bike number 27, has got to finish ahead of 46. Otherwise, 46 will be title. McKinley Carpaz and Aki Aziz, 1 and 2, going into this race. They are out of it. We are coming into the final lap. An incredible, crazy, crazy season is coming down to this final lap of the final race of the season.
Well, I've got to say, Des, I didn't see this coming, but that's what we like about undermine racing. This last lap is going to be the most exciting lap of the year.
Hasik, 27, is in that group. Ahmed Fasnacham, 46, is